You know, I learned this. I'll read it out to you. Daro to pura daro, varna mat daro. Aadha daroge, to hamesha phate. This is something what I have learned when I was in college. I come from Lucknow, and in college, and you know how it is in Lucknow. College politics, gun-wielding people, mad. This is one thing I learned over there. Ki agar dar lag raha hai, then be scared. Don't fool around. And if you're not scared, then go the whole hog. Go the whole hog. And look at me, I'm still alive. I chose not to get scared. And this mantra, this has lived with me for all these years, and it has helped me take the right decisions throughout my life till now. You know, starting, and you find this mantra playing every day in your life, every day. I'll go back a few years and talk about something that a lot of people, I've seen a lot of TEDx videos, and I see every now and then somebody comes here and says that, you know, yeah, some people come and say that, you know, my parents didn't allow me to become a musician, or they were against the idea of me doing something, you know, alternative. The engineers, you know, my parents also said that, definitely. It's a fact. But, and I used to get irritated, you know, when they used to put resistance to my things, my free thinking. I used to feel irritated, and I used to feel, furious at times. But today, when I look back, I think every parent who did that did a very good job. They did an amazing job. You know why? Start practicing convincing your parents, because it's harder, much, 10 times harder to convince people outside your home. You know, your parents want to be sure of your conviction. How convinced are you? Can you convince them first of your own ideas? Then only you'll be able to go out and explain others. So they're doing a very, very good job while doing that, while putting some amount of resistance, because they're testing you out with. I think great thumbs up to all the parents who are actually doing that. I thought at a very early age that, you know, I know music because my mother used to play banjo and wind guitar. My dad plays a lot of instruments. My grandmother was a avadhi singer. She would get invited to sing in various places. And at very young age, I got exposed to all these things. I had, you know, musical instruments as my choice early on. I would play tunes, you know, and I used to think that, yeah, I know, I can. But it never struck to me that, no, I should take it seriously. It was only when my sister, she started taking Hindustani classical vocal lessons and Kathak lessons. So my job would be to go and drop her to her classes and bring her back. So sometimes I would stay back and I would listen to their riyaz and their sessions. I really got interested in the kind of music that they were doing. I really wanted to go and join the class. I tried convincing my parents very hard. Was not successful for some years. But then finally my mother gave in, and she said that okay. She asked one of her family friends, who was also a qualified musician, to take me to a guru. So she took me to a well-known guru in Lucknow. And I went there and the Guruji said, "You better put sunao." So I sang some filmy song. At that time those were things I knew. So I sang a filmy song and he said, "Banji inse nahi hoga." You know, I can't teach him music. I can't. Even if I try, I'll spoil my own voice. Okay? But surprisingly, I look back and I say, I was not dejected. I was not, it didn't shatter my confidence at all. I think I was always an overconfident kid, you know. Neither woman. I'll not be scared. So I went back home and I shared news with my grandmother. She said, "Koi fark nahi hai. You know, you sit with me. I'll make you learn a few things, you know. So sing with me, learn my songs, play harmonium with me." And that's how I started, you know, practicing with her. But then it happened and I moved on in life. Went to college. And I'm really proud. I'm really fortunate that I am from Lucknow. And I went to the college I went. I went to Lucknow Christian College. I was very active in college politics there. So a few things that I learned from the city was, I inherited the language. Beautiful language to speak in Lucknow. I understood politics. Every small kid in Lucknow can teach you about what's happening in India and the political scene, believe me. And through that, I also understood the equations and the relationships between people and things. And of course, Bhokal, very famous in Lucknow, confident, self-assured always, whether you know or not. So, it helps sometimes. And the best part was that Lucknow is a place, the soundscape is a cacophony of amazingly different sounds. You know, one fine evening, you're standing on your rooftop and you hear temple bells, azan, tempo ka horn, saiti ki ghanti, your mother shouting, tum na aangan, niche aajao padhne. Some padosi shouting out that, you know, cable TV nahi aa raha hai. And somewhere you'll hear a bhajan being played out or somebody doing his riyaz. It's a cacophony, it's a concoction which sounds exotic sometimes, you know. And today when I, you know, compose music, I find all those influences coming in. It's really funny, you know, imagine, and in Lucknow, where I grew up, you have these houses which are sticking close to each other and you can actually hop across to people's roofs, and you know, that's how a lot of people meet their girlfriends in the evening. So imagine a guy going and proposing a girl with a red rose, and you would imagine violins playing or maybe some guitars playing, but actually it's tan ta ta tan tan ta ta la tan ta ta tan, and you sing tring tring, and your mother is shouting pappu kahan ho, you know, it's like that. So the soundscape had a great influence on whatever I'm doing today. So after I came to Delhi, I got admission here in IIMC, in the JNU campus, and I came here. Two things happened to me: advertising, which I took as my initially as my career, and then while I was working in an ad agency, I met 3-4 people, brilliantly intelligent people, and I did a short play with them for one of our clients. And I had never done theatre before, or never even seen theatre before. And I did a play, just out of, you know, everybody's doing okay, I'll also do. And I completely fell in love with the idea of doing theatre. And within 3 months of doing that short play, we started a theatre company called Actor Factor Theatre Company. It happens to be one of the most well-known theatre companies in Delhi and in India today. We have done about 14 plays till now. And I didn't start giving music initially. So we did 14 plays, and out of 13 now I have given background scores and I have composed music for. So the second play that we did, so our music director, we fell out with our music director, the relationship didn't work out, and the group had to look inwards and say, hey, can somebody do music, because we cannot afford to have a music director. I said, okay, I know a little bit, I can play a couple of instruments with me. So I did the complete soundtrack of the play. I acted in a small part in the play also. That play was a success, and we also won Sahitya Kala Parishad Puraskar for that play. And since then, I've composed music for all the plays. I've done some short films, I've done some ad films, and now I've been composing songs for our band. One landmark production while I was an Actor Factor was Sounds of Earth. It was based on my research, which said that all folk music in the world is the same. For example, all rice cultivating regions in the world, if you listen to the folk music, they're all based on the same rhythm pattern. Whether it's Assam, Odisha, or Africa, it's the same. You know why? Because music happens when human beings interact with nature. You know? So, how rice is cultivated, like, that's how you do it. You know? You're moving and you're cutting the paddy. So, if you listen to all the folk songs of these regions, they will sound the same, exactly the same, because the rhythm pattern is the same. And similarly for boatman songs, with upstream, downstream, depends on the rhythm pattern of how much pressure you're applying to row the boats. While we were doing this production, I met another set of brilliantly talented musicians, amazingly talented musicians. I'll be introducing to all of them to you right now. And after this production happened, I continued doing theatre, but always used to meet and discuss that, look, let's take this idea further. Let's take this idea further, because we're so much in love with the kind of music that we made during that time. And out of that discussion and deliberation, idea to create a band called Folka Dots happened. Folka Dots, why? Because while we were doing folk music, we saw that folk music is usually associated with rural areas, you know, countryside. What about the folks living in the urban areas? Don't we have our own folk music? Sounds funny. You know, we're also human beings, we have a routine, so some music should emerge out of it. And that's where the idea happened, and I would like to invite Biswajit Das. He's an amazing percussionist and an amazing arranger. And I request Biswajit to talk about a little bit about the philosophy of Folka Dots and how it happened.
Thank you. You normally have to pay for an introduction like that, right? So, most of our music, like you said, comes because we didn't fear in trusting our instincts and did what we wanted to do, but also in parts because of our ignorance. You see, me and Shashwat are self-taught musicians. We didn't have an orthodox education in music. So there were a lot of things we didn't know. For example, we didn't know that you can't take an instrument like this, which is a Spanish instrument, signature sound for a lot of Lucknow music, and take a folk song from the gullies of Lucknow and base it on this. Nobody told us. So we did it. I mean, or for example, we didn't know the song sung by a poor fisherwoman from the rural areas of Bengal, a boatman's wife. Another song sung by a poor woman from Punjab, singing for love of Almighty. There is no way that you can put these two together and make one single single song. Again, nobody told us. So we did it anyways, right? Because we believe music is organic. It comes from our environment, it comes from who we are, our personal experiences, where have we been, what have we seen, what have we felt, etc., etc. And therefore, I think all of it comes naturally, right? What do we play? We play urban folk music. Why urban folk? What urban folk? See, all of us, at least in the band, a lot of you here, are urban gypsies. We come from various parts of India, settle in the urban areas. So we bring our own sensibilities from our childhood of the music that we heard. Right? All our music is from this desire to take these fabulously cool folk tunes and bring our own current sensibilities, because our influences are very current, like 80s, 90s, the new millennium, and make them folk music for urban folks. Right? So at this point of time, I'd like to introduce you to some other people who have been a part of this, so to say, musical leap of faith. And Vaishali Kazavati, personifies the lilting, haunting, beautiful, simple melodies from the folk traditions of East and Northeast of India. Devanshi, she has this brilliant, beautiful, earthy voice, which always has been visualizing these sarso ke khet in a very non-yashraj way, you know. And we have now, we have somewhat of a fruit prodigy, Kartikeya? Yes. He's just become eligible to vote a while back. And I don't use the word prodigy here very lightly, as you'll see in a while, right? Being urban gypsies, we all travel a lot. Not only to see the sights of India, but also, you know, soak in and bask in the musical traditions. Kartikeya, for example, travels a lot to Rajasthan. And we've seen whenever we travel, some part of that music always seeps into one of our songs. And you know, reflects in a music scene. So when Kartik was in Rajasthan, he came across this typical flute playing style called Leher. And at the same time, we were composing this song called Ghor, which is a song of modern rebellion. And technically, the two should never meet, but you know, nobody told us, right? So we went ahead and did it. This is the first thing that we'll play on a small sampler of the three of our songs, which will tell you about our musical philosophies and styles, right? So let the music do the rhythm.
Oh,
sound, which is very, very, you know, evident and very, very peculiar when you see the soundscape of Lucknow, is there are kite flyers everywhere, and they are fanatics. There's kite, it's not only kite flying, so literally there's a fight happening, and there's live commentary happening. People are beating canisters, and they are betting, and it's maddening. And this is what it sounds like. We are urban gypsies, which means that we don't have a base, we keep traveling.